The day I graduated college in 2005, I decided to start a rental company. It took a few years until it became successful enough to be my full-time job, but now it's all I do. My hope is to help you by sharing my knowledge. This video is for all of you who have trailers, and my friend Gorth Balian, that is you too. But I started with an SUV, my mom's SUV, and then I bought a little tiny truck, a Chevy S10, and then I got a open trailer from Gander Mountain Bass Pro type shop, and then I jumped right into renting trucks for the summer. So I hate trailers. I don't like trailers. I like trucks with lift gates. But I do also understand you got to start somewhere. You probably already have a pickup truck, and it's much cheaper to get a trailer than it is to buy a box truck or rent a box truck every summer. But so trailers is how I started too, and it's how most people are going to start. But there's a problem with trailers. There's the transitions. There's the transition between the ground and the ramp, and then the ramp, there's like a gap to the actual trailer. And things can get stuck in there, and if you have things on wheels, it's really difficult to get things up. I had a trailer until this past year. The person who delivered dishes is the one who used it. I had to use it in the winter because I don't rent trucks for the winter, and if it's a small enough job, we would just use the trailer and things wouldn't get all snowy or wet. So I was using a trailer every single winter, and I hated it because, like I said, all my chairs are on wheels and they would just get stuck. So I did some research. I went into a trailer place and found out what there was that could solve the solution. And it's really simple. They're called trailer transitions or trailer lips or whatever. Basically, the main transition from the trailer to the ramp, you know, that 4 to 6 inch gap, there's a thing that flips up and down that crosses that transition. It makes everything easy. You don't get your wheels stuck in there. And even if you're just using a hand car or hand truck, it just makes it a whole lot smoother. Plus, maybe you don't get caught in there, you don't trip. So that flips up and down when it's not being used. You flip it up, close the trailer. And then from the ramp to the ground, you know, there's a little bit of a transition there. So there's a simple thing for that too. It's just another thing that flips down. It's a little longer. It can be made out of diamond plate or wood. And it just makes the hole from inside the trailer down to the ground smooth and vice versa, all smooth. It just makes life a whole lot easier. So I bought these for the trailer. We had it for about 3 years, and it made my life easier. The dish guy didn't care because he's carrying in and out dishes and stuff. But me trying to have things on wheels, trying to deliver stacks of 15 tables on wheels and then get them back on without having a fight with it, it was great for me. I think the whole thing costs about $250. You could probably find them cheaper, and you self-install them. You just drill them in, and like I said, they fold so that you can get them out of the way and close your trailer, and they just save tons of time. It makes trailer life a whole lot easier. So I understand you're going to be probably starting with a trailer. You'll probably still have a trailer for a few years when you get big, and then maybe you decide you just hate trailers like I do. Thanks for watching.